In the last video, I took the bull by the horn, so to speak, and cut the redesigned plates out of Acetal as I had designed them in Fusion 360. And in this video, I'm going to complete the upgrade by assembling the new parts. In some respects, it would have been easier just to build a new CNC machine to make it in two sections, the base with the gantry and the spindle, and just to join them together. Now I'm going to have to... It was very difficult to imagine dismantling and reassembling the machine without making the process convoluted. In retrospect, I should have dismantled the entire thing and rebuilt it in a manner which might help someone coming to it for the first time. Alas, it's not my first time. I've been here before. This project has been going on for so long, I often think I can smell the pongy odour of that unusual cheese, déjà vu. So the new plate's going to have an extra foot here, so I may need to cut a little strip on this so that I can have that making contact with the table. I decided to begin by dismantling the front motor plates. For the one with the proximity sensor and with subsequent ones, I had to cut a little notch to free the cable from the wooden plate. I didn't want to unsolder and remove all the wiring. Could have been a surgeon. After replacing the plates, I kept the stepper motors off as I would have to move the TR8 thread at some point, and the motors would just get in the way. I then turned the machine around and removed the opposite plates, this time so I could access the Y plates. I think I need to put something under here to stop that from dropping. I'm going to take these three machine screws off, cut that, pull this out, and then take the gantry out. Okay, so before I put this on, this entire section has come out. I just had to replace the two machine screws here, which are holding the Z axis, with these low profile ones, just because it was hitting on the aluminium extrusion. Loosen these up a bit. Okay, that looks all right. These things have saved me on many occasions. Okay, this didn't occur to me. This is where I noticed some new mistakes. When I cut my anti-backlash nut blocks, I had inadvertently flipped the DXF illustration. Luckily, when I designed the plates though, I based the opening on the nut block available on the Open Builds Parts store, so someone building this CNC machine doesn't have to make their own nut blocks as well. But I have four openings, of which three are in the right place for the ones available on the parts store, but not the ones I cut myself. What I decided to do was move one of the nut block tensioning windows on the Y plate so it had the correct orientation for the ones which could be purchased. I've updated the files for the CNC machine, but it looks like I'll have to carry on for now. I'm just going to replace these angle brackets just because there's these little notches here which will press into the acetal, and this stuff is so hard it will just bend. Luckily I've got a few of these. Got to try put this under there now. I've just put some brackets in the corners here, there, and on the other side. Something I'm meaning to do for some time. However, what this does mean is the aluminium under here will touch onto the screw, so I lose a few mil on either side now. Okay, I've done it here as well. That's really annoying. Okay, the low profile machine screws have turned up. I checked the X, Y, and Z movement, and it all seemed okay. The next thing I need to do is embed a piece of metal onto the edge of the plates so the proximity sensor can detect incoming parts. I decided to use small M3 grub screws to do this.
So what I'm doing is I'm only going a small amount of the way, so the grub screw has to sink into a little bit of just untapped acetal, and that should hopefully hold it and stop it from vibrating loose. Otherwise I'd have to leave that out and lock it down with an extra nut. So since I've mirrored these on this side here, the proximity mounts, this one's hitting onto it right there. Now I've cut it. That's sorted, and you can see there's about 5-6 mil clearance there. This one's a little bit more tricky because the surface I'm drilling into is curved, but that's also why I curved the material so there's a bit more there to drill into. But also I've got the brackets under here, so I need to make sure that the wheel doesn't hit onto that. It's really hard to see. I need like a dentist mirror. I can already see the spindle. It's about a fair bit over on this side.
I then inserted another grub screw onto the opposite side of the gantry. The new design of the plates, along with the narrower spindle mount, has increased the cutting capacity of the machine.
So now the bit is overhanging by about 50 millimeters, so I should be able to actually pull this forward and do some finger joins on a piece of 9 or 12 mil. That's not bad. And I guess if the bit is a little bit bigger, I might even get through an 18 mil. And I still have a few mil that I could actually move forward as well. From the home position, moving forward until the red light turned on, I counted 33.4 centimeters. So that's already a lot bigger than my current waste board, which is 32. But I think I have brought this forward a little bit, so I'd lose a bit of space at the back. Okay, the final thing I've done is cut out a adapter ring so the dust chute can still be used on this machine. I really didn't fancy going through that process all over again. It's very simple. I used the DXF file that I had originally designed to create a kind of elliptical shape with a hole cut out in the center, and it fits perfectly. I glued it down with dichloromethane plastic cement. I've obviously blocked some of the holes so I can't get the magnets out, but this dust chute is working really well. And actually, for the size of the machine, it's really convenient to be able to pop the brushes on underneath like that, take them out, and have access all the way around.
So that's the CNC machine assembled. It's a shame I accidentally mirrored the anti-backlash nut blocks, but the threads are under tension. And if I have to, I could always make some new ones with the correct orientation, or just buy some from the parts store. This machine feels very sturdy, and I'm happy with the outcome. So it's time for me to say thanks again for watching, for sacrificing those thumbs along the way, and in particular to all the patrons who have supported this channel and build. In the next video, I will level the wasteboard, square the axes, and tram the spindle.